Ciao, hello everybody. Welcome, welcome, welcome to this episode of Gordon's Wednesday Training. Excited to jump on real quick and share with you another topic that should be interesting for a lot of reasons. So before we get started, let me know where you're coming from, my friends. Type in the comments below. I want to see your country flag. I want to see where you're coming from so I can give you a quick shout out as well. And it's good to see you on as well. So it's been a rainy day today. I don't know what is the temperature, where you're at, or maybe it's summer. I don't know, maybe it's winter. Tell me all about it. Tell me all about it in the comments below. So just quickly checking if everything is okay with the sound. Let's see.
Hello.
All right. What's up, Rafael? My buddy from Poland is crushing it. Awesome. So good to see you, my friend. doing good, man. Good to see you. So we're going to talk about, in today's basically topic training, we're going to talk about the 13 powerful ways to overcome self-doubt so you can finally move forward in life. And who did not ever self-doubted themselves in order to move forward? Because we have patches. We pass through patches in life. And I'm sure that some of us, or if not, to be honest, all of us, have passed or will pass. If you're just starting something, maybe your own business, maybe you started a new diet, maybe you started running again, maybe you started walking again, right? So again, type number one, if you ever had self-doubt, okay? It's time to be honest with ourselves, because I've been plenty of times. And into this episode, we're gonna talk about all about this, 13 powerful ways that you can overcome, that will help you overcome. So what I want you to do before I get started, so your friends, maybe you know someone that is gonna need this. So tag them while we are just getting started, tag them down below so they can check out this, or you can share this around as well. In fact, I want to start with this quote by William Shakespeare that says, "Our doubts are traitors and make us lose the good we oft might win by fearing to attempt." Okay, so it is something that will, it's a traitor, with something that will allow us to be in a position that we don't do anything, we don't move forward. So let's start with number one. Okay, let's start with number one. And number one is pretty say stop. Okay, number one is say stop, because in your mind, say or shout something like, this is what can help you: no, we're not going down that road again. So you've got to hack your mind because of the power of the tongue. Like my mentor Johnny Wimby always says, the power of the tongue reveals if you're going to use it for bad things or positive things in your life. So this is the same thing, but this time you say stop in your mind. If it's something that you should say stop at because it will create more doubt, say stop. And it starts by saying, no, I'm not going to go that route again. I'm not going to go that road again. So by doing so, you're disrupting the thought pattern, because we have thought patterns. You see, you can see someone by their own actions, their own excuses, their own whatever it is. It's all connected because they created a pattern. It's like you created a pattern to go to work. You know which road you're gonna pass, which street to do a shortcut towards your work, or which train are you gonna get. You create a pattern. Okay, so again, by doing so, start creating and disrupting actually the thought pattern and stop that inner self-doubter from taking over. Okay, so that's number one, stop saying stop. Number two, let's move to number two. Number two is look to the past as a lesson sort of thing, okay? And wash yourself in the memories. So when you be real with yourself and ask yourself, how many times when I doubted myself or maybe feared something would happen, okay, something happened, would happen, did that negative thing come into reality after I still took action? So did that something negative came into reality? Because most of the time, because we're thinking about that, that's what's gonna happen. Okay, that's why we start complaining, and that's when more self-doubt is being increased into our lives. So The answer for me, and probably for you too, it is not very often at all, because as I said, when you, what you expect, what you focus on expands. So you're focusing on doubt, you gotta have more doubt. If you're focusing on negatives, you gotta be, have more negatives. If you focus on positives, that's what you, what you're gonna get, okay? More positive. So again, look to the past, look from your history, okay? And learn from it. It's okay, you messed up, it's okay. A lot of people do every single time, but are you gonna do something different, or are you still gonna do what you did in the past? And this is why it's not allow you to move forward. So that's number two. Now, number three, talk to someone about it. And I believe this is one of my favorite, okay? I'm gonna start with giving you my favorites and some other pointers in here, because when you are, maybe you're working with somebody, we're working with a mentor, you're working with someone and they live far from you, or maybe you're working on something that you are alone at the moment, you're working alone, you can encounter a lot of self-doubt, you know, people are gonna say a lot of things, they're not gonna agree with your vision, whatever it is, okay, that you're doing. So you've got to talk it out, you've got to let it out by talking to someone. So when you keep your thoughts on the inside, they can become distorted, okay? They can become distorted, exaggerated, and not very much in line with the reality or reasonable expectations. So you've got to really let and check off your ego and just talk to someone. Even if they just listen, that will help you a lot, because what we keep inside between our ears, it's like a war. It's a war zone in here, right? When we start creating or exaggerating the doubt, okay? In fact, it expands again. And it could be something just by talking to somebody. So if you're passing from that, or maybe you just talk with someone. In fact, a couple of days ago, actually yesterday, I did a session with a team, with my friend as well. And we just wanted to listen. We didn't go, wanted to give a training. We just wanted to listen, because I know that they have something to let go of, to let out, and we can help them better that way. So that's number three, my friends. Okay, so moving forward to number four. If you like it so far, hit the thumbs up button. See what's up, Andreas. Good to see you, my friend. What's up, Regina? All the way from Spain. Are you in Spain? Are you in Spain or in Naples? If you're in Naples, hit me up. I'm gonna be in Naples, in Italy, next month. Excited, my very first time in Italy, Naples, okay? Naples, Italy, not Naples, Florida. Okay. So moving on, let's move on to number four. So number four is, don't get stuck in the comparison trap. I'm gonna say it again. Do not get stuck in the comparison trap. Why? A lot of people do. Try to compare themselves when they got started. It's because they are not having the same results as somebody else. This is when it creates that sense of inner self-doubt without saying anything, but it creates this inner self-doubt that will crush them. That will crush them into ashes, basically. So stop. If you do that, stop comparing your results or comparing yourself with somebody else. So a better way to go about things is to compare yourself, but you know with who? With you. See where you started? You increase your skills, you increase your behavior, you increase your attitude without forgetting where you're coming from. That's what you should be grateful for, because you're another person. And if you train yourself, if you develop yourself, once you go and talk with people, within a few months, they already see change. You're not gonna see it because it's you, but other people will see it. The way you talk, the way you express yourself, it's different than when you got started. The same thing, this is why we go to school, right? We go to school to improve ourselves, not to compare yourself with the teacher, but to compare yourself from where you started, kindergarten, up to high school, or whatever it is that someone arrived at their education. So Never compare yourself with anybody else. Just always try to focus on improving yourself and compare with who were you before you started your venture, before you started your business, before we started whatever it is that you're doing. Okay? So to see how far you've come, that's why. You need to measure. That's great. You need to measure how far you've come. And it's okay if you're not in the position that you wanted to be or you want to be. Sometimes little tweaks can make a huge difference. So that's my take on number four. Okay, don't get stuck in the comparison trap. Number five, moving on. Start keeping a journal. If you are into this issue, if you have this issue of self-doubt, something that can and could help you is keeping a journal for basically helpful habits, okay, for many reasons. When it comes to self-doubt, it can help you to keep a realistic record of your life, okay, and also gain clarity more easily. Gain clarity more easily is because you will divide the pros and cons of what you're doing, and if they don't work, just ditch them and focus on what's working for you, okay? So again, keep a realistic record of your life, another thing, and gain clarity more easily. So by writing, I mean, some people, it's funny, I mean, you might know someone that they always say, right, can you write for me because I forget? I mean, that's not the right way to go about it. If you forget and you know you forget, what are you doing to not continue with this habit? Because you cannot tell people, anyone that you meet, everyone that you meet, right? Can you write it down? Can you do this? No, people have their own life. It's you that you need to hack that issue. So suggestion is get this journal, and if they tell you a number, I'm not good with numbers, okay? I'm trying to improve every time, but what I do is like they give me phone numbers. I cannot remember, so what I do is I write. Some of you has this extreme to extreme level, write down, write everything, okay? If you go to events, trainings, and you just stay like this, okay? And you don't take notes, was that valuable for you just by listening? No, why? Because when you step out of that event, you're only gonna remember small percentage, okay? Small, just really small percentage that stuck to your head. Otherwise, if you don't have to take notes, you're not gonna get most of the value of that event that you probably paid for a lot of money, right? So number six, remember, people don't care that much about what you do or you say. Remember, people don't care that much about what you do or what you say. So this is when people get all the time worried. They worry about what others may think or say or tell them, okay? Because we have this habit to buy and purchase and hire other people's opinion. So you do good. This is something that I've learned. You do good. Imagine, you do good. You do great. People are still going to judge you. People are going to think something about you, okay? Same thing as this video. You might think this, or you might think the other way. You might think, this is BS, this is fantastic, you're still gonna think, right? So if you have that zero emotional attachment with what other people think, you have more belief in yourself automatically, because this, okay, is what's putting you in a position to not put more action, to not move forward in life. This is, you see it a lot of times. I mean, if you are someone that you sing, for example, okay? Do you think that, pick up a band, Imagine Dragons. I was listening to Imagine Dragons. If you like it, thumbs up. I love Imagine Dragons, great, great songs and great lyrics. So do you think if you go and watch a movie, they have millions and billions of viewers on their video, all are gonna be good? No, you're gonna see hate. The haters are always jumping in, and the comments, you can see the comments, people are so creative in that, but that's another topic, right? And do you think that Imagine Dragons are gonna go and read and let that negative post because someone said, I don't like the shirt of the singer? Like, come on, okay? I don't gotta affect them to not producing more music, to not doing more songs. No, okay, because they don't care about what people say or do. So the same way as you, if you have a business, if you have been for a while, you might know, if nobody told you, that you're gonna have people that are gonna judge you, you're gonna say, what the hell are you doing, man? Go get a job, okay? So it's the same thing if you're running, okay? When I run for the very first time, because I wanted to do a half marathon, okay? So it was like an obsession. I wanted to do it as I was still working as a chef at the time, working crazy hours. I was running like midnight in here. Nobody, you can see nobody in here. It's crazy. Sometimes it's rain. Doesn't matter for me because I wanted to do it. That's it. It's not about the timing, the best timing, or to finish first, second. For me, it was like I wanted to do it. 21 kilometers. Boom. So guess what? If I listened to everybody that I was surrounded at that time, you know, I went out, people, friends were laughing at me because I wasn't drinking alcohol with them, but I was drinking juice or water, you know, because they didn't know my goal. If I listened to what they were saying, I probably did not do it, and I did it second time as well, which I improved even my time because I worked more mentally than just physically. So this is huge, and a lot of people suffer from this because they post to see how many likes they're gonna get. It's not about that. It's about you post something that you wanted to share with others. If not, why are you posting it? To be liked with others? Come on. It's common sense sometimes, but common sense is not that common, right? Number seven, moving on. What someone says or did might not be about you or about what you think it is. Sometimes we interpret this on a completely wrong way, because when someone criticizes you, then it's easy to start doubting yourself. And you have to be open, okay? Especially when you're running your own business or you're doing something for the community, or you're doing something, you wrote a book, whatever it is, write a song, or you published something, you are gonna be open to public criticism. Now, some is a bad criticism, some is constructive criticism. So when someone rejects you, if you ever watch like Dragon's Den or Shark Tank, you see a lot of people being rejected, their offer or whatever it is, their products or their businesses. Okay, the sharks, they're rejecting more than they accept, and they invest in these people. So do you think that with what they say, the sharks, okay, you should just tell, if they tell you, look, this sucks, man, you should close down, you should, like Kevin O'Leary, you should shoot it in the barn or something like that, like, and you just stop. If you believe in that, okay, that it can change somebody's life, it can give more value to people, you should just take that lesson, okay, and you're gonna have audience because you are on Shark Tank, and you take it to the next level. Hire a coach that can help you move to the next step, or whatever that needs to be done to go to the next level, if you believe this can help you. So it doesn't shut down because somebody in Shark Tank said it, but if you believe it and you see good reason for you continue, just continue. Same thing. So this is how important to handle criticism, bad and work on the tips that they gave you to improve it. It's good. Okay, it's good. It's the same thing on TripAdvisor. You see a lot of people putting their reviews, right, about restaurants and accommodations and stuff like that. So if the restaurant received, I don't know how many bad reviews, okay, they should improve on how. What is the common denominator there? Is it because there's no air conditioning in summer in 40 degrees Celsius, okay, in summer? Is it the same Every review? You should invest in an air conditioner. But sometimes, again, they're gonna be bad reviews because of how people operate. Because people are, there's pessimism and there's optimism. So you cannot do about that, really. So number eight, Okay, number 8, get a boost of optimism. I just mentioned that. So let someone else's enthusiasm, motivation, and constructive optimism flow into your veins, my friends. So this is why you should hang around the best people possible that are motivated, that have energy, okay? Don't hang out with people who are negative, pessimist, and all that, okay? Stay away, run away. If you meet them, say hello, and you run. Okay, this is very, very important. This is why some of you, their energy is so low. Okay, you're not gonna make even a dog bark. Okay, you're not gonna wake any senior people in your area. So you've got to hang around better people, stronger people, strong-minded people, people who have energy, people who are willing, are ambitious, are willing to go to the next level, willing to go forward. If you don't have them around you, I already know the result. You've got to hang around them. If they live far, sometimes you need to go outside of your comfort zone, go fly, take a plane, and stuff like that. Okay? It's for your own benefit because your surroundings will define who you are going to be and who you become. So that's number 8. Okay? So you can have a mentor, you can have someone. So we do sessions. I mean, we do sessions with team members. I don't do anything else with other people at the moment because time is very limited. So sometimes I spend 15 minutes, 20 minutes. I do this every day with someone new in my team, and I give them value. Okay, I cannot stand when someone say, "Can you call me because I need motivation?" It's not about that because motivation is like motivation wears off. So what is suggesting, what is that ticks? What is that gives you motivation? Is it a song? Is it a speech? Is it an audio? In fact, spend some time in getting that motivation inside of you, especially if you go to pitch something, if you go to do a presentation, if you go to do a business deal, okay? If you go with that lack of energy, you're not going to have and close the deal. So spend 20 minutes with an audio, podcast. Nowadays, we have everything. Okay, a book that gives you that. Number 9, see a setback as temporary, not permanent. See a setback as temporary. You know, the comeback kids, the comeback people, okay, know what it means for this because a setback is just puts you in a position to come back. So what you have a setback, then you may start to see things through a negative and dark lens. So remember, there's 2 things. Remember, you are not a failure just because you failed. If someone that created this, okay, that created this, didn't fail 1,000 times or more than that, do you think nowadays we're going to have this to use it every single day, to touch it? I don't know how many times, thousands of times every day. No. So they failed, they tweaked, they moved forward, they failed again, they tweaked, they moved forward, they tweaked again. We couldn't even have internet or light so you can see us, so we can communicate this way. So setbacks happens to everyone, but everyone who takes chances. Another thing is ask yourself, maybe what is the one thing I can learn from this setback? This could be a great question. What is one thing that you have learned from your last setback? Are you going to repeating the same mistakes or are you going to tweak something and move forward? So use this, the mistake or failure, whatever it is you call it, to your advantage and move forward once again in a smarter way. Number 10. So 3 more left and we'll wrap this up. So if you like this so far, let me know in the comments below. Type in number 2 if you like it so far and share this around and click the hearts button, thumbs up button as well. If you're watching this on YouTube, make sure you subscribe to the YouTube channel and click on the notification bell as well. So you receive this kind of videos every single time that we upload. Number 10, sharpen your skills, my friends. Again, a lot of people, they just do it when they like or when they wake up to do it. They want to wake up to do it. Just just that kind of mindset. So you've got to sharpen your skills. If you, for instance, often get self-doubt before a presentation, okay, before, I don't know, an event, a training that you're gonna do, guess what? If you're not prepared, if you're not sharpening your skills, if you're not reading previous days, if you're not listening to someone, listening to an audio that will help you improve your skills, if you're not practicing, okay, if you're not practicing what you should do to run your business, guess what? It's gonna create a disaster. So you've got to sharpen your skills, go to events, learn from people, talk with people, okay, network with people. This is what it's all about. Sharpen your skills. Number 11, don't beat yourself up about it. Okay, so a common way to handle and self-doubt is to get angry at yourself or and your lack of motion. Try to beat yourself up as a way to get yourself to move forward. That does not basically help much, isn't it? So what you need to do is you need to criticize yourself. That's okay. But see what you did focus on the right things, because at school, you see, you remember when you were at school, what they taught us is if you get 7 good and 3 wrong, they focus on why and the reason why you get them wrong. That's okay. But they don't tell you anything about you get 7, much more than 50% good. So we are accustomed to like handling badly negative criticism. So when something bad happens to us, we quit. If we get a no, we quit. If your diet is not going right after a week, you quit. If you went for a week to the gym and then the next week you went 3 times or maybe once, the next then week you're gonna quit. So every small step, you should be grateful of the small steps that you're taking, because without action there's no motion. But again, don't beat yourself up if self-doubt kicks in, because everybody has that. But again, make sure that you are moving forward, you are tweaking to move forward. Because I mean, question is, what is one very small step I can take to move forward in this situation? Okay, in the situation that you're in. Number 12, we're getting close, guys. Number 12. So number 12 is celebrate that small step and win. If you reach the rank in your company, if you won a contest in your company, if you won a promotion, whatever it is, if you enroll someone new in your team, if you celebrate, but you don't celebrate for the whole year. You celebrate, you stop for a second, you get that motivation in, you recharge, you're more pumped, and you do it again. You move forward to reach the next destination, to reach, to get more people in your organization, whatever it is. So celebrate that small step. It's good. It's healthy. Sometimes you people put contests, small contests, you win a book, great. You win a meal, you win a dinner, you win a pizza out with friends. So whatever it is, small things. And you can do it as well to motivate your team, okay, your members, because companies organize big promotions, okay? But are you creating something smaller, on a smaller scale, that's not gonna break your bank, to let others in your team celebrate that small step as well, so they keep themselves motivated as well? Think about that. Last one, okay, last one. We made it. So last one, remember, you can course correct along the way. Which means you can course correct along the way, which means when you're trying to plan every move you will make, you're gonna make on your journey towards a goal or dream, can become draining, isn't it? And lead quite to a bit of self-doubt. So it's good to plan, but it's good even better to do. So start doing without just trying to make the pattern or your journey as a plan perfect, because it's not gonna happen. And you can see it in movies, okay? You can see it in anything that someone planned, the fantastic heist, whatever. I mean, I was watching Money Heist in English, Casa de Papel, okay? La Casa de Papel, I think, is in Spanish. I love it, okay? This guy that is called Professor, he planned every inch for the biggest heist. But guess what? Along the journey, things happened, you know? Challenges happened. But what they did is they fixed it. They turned around. So this is very important. Just go do it. Just do it. Because that planning, over-planning and over-planning and over-preparing will create self-doubt. So do a bit of rough planning and then start your journey. This is my last message here. If you made it so far, congratulations to you. Type in number 3 in the comments below if you made it so far. I want to see number 3. If you made it so far, congratulations to you. Thank you for watching this. Thank you for participating in this. I hope you loved it. Text someone that needs this. Share this around. Click the thumbs up button. If you're watching this once again on YouTube, make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel. There you go. Here it is. Okay, YouTube channel. And click on the notification bell for more videos like this. You can check out also more free trainings on my website. That's www.gordonattard.com. That's GordonAttard. Happy to have you on in my inner circle as well. There's some free gifts that I'm giving away. So that's all. I have you have a great rest of the day, my friends, wherever you are watching us from. And I'll see you on probably next Wednesday, if not in the next upcoming trainings on here. Thanks for following. Thanks for watching, my friends. Take care and bye-bye.